Hey guys, this is Janine from Pangolin Photo Safaris, and today I want to speak to you about keywording your photographs in Lightroom, why it is such a massive advantage, and how you can do it without wasting too much time on it. If you do enjoy our videos, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button just down below here in order to get notifications for all the new videos coming up. Alright, let's get started. Keywords on Lightroom is a love-hate relationship many people have. A lot of people have heard about it but don't take the time to use them. Others make use of them frequently or infrequently. But let me tell you something. Keywording is a secret weapon everybody should make use of because it is a fantastic way of organizing your photographs. The problem many people have is to initially structure your photograph. You can see here in my Lightroom, I've gone chronological, but obviously I can't always remember which month, day, or year I have done certain events. So you need further assistance. And if you put it into further folder structures, you can do it via trips, events, occasions, family members, themes. At the end, it never quite fits together. Let me give you an example. I used to have folder structures for every single animal. I would have elephants, in kudus, in crocodiles. So I have all my elephants together. But then I would travel into a different country. And I would also like to now have a Namibia folder. But there I shoot elephants, but they're now not in my elephant folder. So you couldn't cross-reference. So this is now the beauty with keywording. With keywording, you can suddenly cross-reference your images. If you have a look here on my Lightroom screen, I chose an area where I have a sequence of shots, which in nature photography is often the case, as animals are moving fast and you usually trigger more than once. And if you go into your grid view down here, then you'll have a library filter coming up. If you cannot see the section, you can go up to your view and you can tick show your filter bar. That will make it much easier for you. So if you have your filter bar visible, you will see you can filter via text. And in my 2017 year, if you now look for two or three specific themes at the same time, I could now say hippo charging and it would show all my charging hippo pictures. Or I could say birds fishing. It will show me all my birds that are potentially busy fishing at the moment. In my year 2017, I can obviously also search for the same thing all throughout my entire library, and I will get quite a lot of results, all of which are birds that are fishing. I will save a tremendous amount of time. When exactly? For instance, if you look for specific prints, you want to redecorate your house and it's supposed to have a specific theme, black and white or baby animals. Or if you look to make a picture album, if you want to participate in competitions, all these sort of things, you would have to go through your entire photo library to find suitable photographs, which can take days, if not weeks sometimes. With your Lightroom keywording, if you keyword from the start, you can enter keywords such as locations, editing techniques, light situations, behavior, portraits, and you'll find, for instance, that nature competitions are often structured the same way. You have the same categories, such as mammal portraits, mammal behavior, bird behavior. And if you go and check out my keywording down here, you will find that I have things like mammal portraits or mammal behavior in there. If I have a photograph that I find very intriguing with respect to the behavior, or particularly good, and I find it's competition worthy, I give it a label for a potential category that it can fit in. That way, once a competition comes up, I don't have to search for it forever. If I go into my bird behavior, that's what I want to see, not just behavior. And those are all images that I find sort of interesting when it comes to the behavior of the specific bird, such as the jacana breeding behavior, or the pike kingfisher fishing, or the Allen's gallinule trying to steal the lily flower. So that way you can really shorten your time, make it so much faster to look for your images. Now you say, okay, I can see that, but I still don't have enough time in order to keyword. Let me convince you, it doesn't take that long. I'm currently busy keywording in retrospective, and let me tell you, that takes a tremendous amount of time. So don't do the same mistake having to keyword 40,000 images within your library. The way I'd suggest you do it, every time you import your images, and every time you have time to go through your images the first time, immediately keyword them. As I said earlier, usually you have sequences. If your sync settings are correct, you can grab them all together by pressing shift and keyword them all together at once. Botswana, charging, Chobe, hippo, sunset, wildlife, both in the matrix version as well as in the full view. As long as you have auto sync pressed, it will keyword all of them that have been highlighted. You'll see high key has a little star because not every single image will have the keyword high key on there, only the ones that are black and white. I have keyworded as I edited afterwards. But by taking this whole lump, I've immediately keyworded four rows of my images here. So now I can go through them one by one by one to decide which one I want to keep. Once you're done, you continue onwards and you do the next stack. And that way you add maybe 10 minutes, maybe maximum 15 minutes to your overall process of going through your images once. But now you have them keyworded, which is amazing. So if you say, yeah, I'm a very slow typer and I feel this is quite difficult, you'll see once you have a set of keywords set up, if I would now want to add silhouettes, for instance, I just have to type the first three letters and silhouette comes up as a suggestion by my Lightroom because I've used it so many times. You can press enter, return, and that way you would add the keyword silhouette. So even a slow typer has no excuse. Once you've set up a decent word of keyword lists, it makes it much quicker. You even have keyword suggestions down here of keywords you use particularly often. However, my keyword list is so big that my little keyword suggestion set is not big enough. You can have a custom keyword set that you always add for outdoor, for portrait, for wedding photography. Again, I find wildlife photography too versatile and the light conditions too versatile to use my custom sets. To give you one last example, mostly I work in the Chobe. In this instance, I've done a holiday to Cuba. So if you have a look here in my matrix section, I can go through this as all street photography in Cuba. I'd grab the first picture, I would scroll through all the way to my last image, which is down here, press shift and press them all together. Now you can keyword them all together as one. Cuba, street photography, holiday, whatever comes to mind that's relevant for you that you could look for, you do that. After you're done with that, you will now go through them one by one. And while I was in Cuba, I was doing a lot of panning shots. So now, as I go through them one by one, you see some of them have been deleted. You can grab all of these panning shots that I've done together. Some of them are quite funky. And you see I've keyworded them previously in one go, Cuba, holiday, people, street photography. But now I want to add something, and I want to add panning. Boom. All these now have one extra keyword. It took me a split second, and I have one more keyword to find them by. Very, very cool, very easy going. And if you do it every single time and you're consequent and disciplined, you're gonna give up 10 to 15 minutes of your day rather than giving up hours of searching and retrospective once you're looking for your images again. Give it a try. Let me know how you do it and how it works for you in the comment section down below. Very often you just have to get that inner yourself to do it, and then it's a really cool way of getting organized. Bye-bye.